Until me as a black man look at my queen and say, look, I know that woman is what I need to drive me. That woman is what I need to make me complete. Mm-hmm. That woman is what I need to make me have a family with kids. And that woman is who I need to help me keep my kids straight, my household straight. Something that's going to complete. I know this completes me. Until we realize that about our black women, then we don't.
Because this is valuable.
But you know what? And we just got brainwashed again. I say it all the time. Most kids, even call females, bro. Hey, bro. Hey, what's going on, bro? I never understood that.
Right.
Now, you masculating into women now. You know what I'm talking about? You don't even see her as a black queen.
As a queen. Okay, but listen.
That's bro.
My son does that from time to time.
Let me say this. What is a man supposed to do when a black queen doing herself the same way? Doing it to her own self.
We just seen it tonight. On the Housewives of Atlanta.
Don't get me wrong. It goes both ways. When a man or a black man is not.
We got to stop pointing fingers.
Right.
Because when we understand our self-worth, we going to stop them like.
First of all,
if you hear your son calling you bro, you know your self-worth, you're going to stop and hold up.
Listen, I know you should talk
to me, bro.
Me, as a man, as a husband, if I hear a son calling her that, I need to That's a woman.
Yeah. That's a queen.
A queen, yeah. Right. Right. That's your mother that gave that. You should
respect her.
Exactly.
Right.
And you ain't saying nothing wrong by doing that. You're not doing anything wrong by doing it.
Because that's what wrong to it today.
No, that's only the right thing. That's where you begin to show the point.
Community correction. The white man's going to correct you.
Back in the day.
The law going to correct you.
Right.
The prison system, judicial system going to correct
you. Black folks ain't
going to correct you.
But there is no community correction.
It's no community correction, but back in the day.
We had it.
If you got in trouble at my house, you will get beat. And then down there, hey, I'm sending so-and-so down here. Well, you can be back with crazy ass on there.
Back in the day, people used love more than anything. Think about back in the day if y'all saw a bro disrespecting a queen.
You gonna take
y'all would pull him to the side and rough his ass up.
Yeah.
Sure.
Nah.
Like how you saw, right now, if we were passing a couple arguing and to the point where we probably seen the dude slap his wife or girlfriend, what we gonna do? We gonna dry the fuck out. We gonna be like, ain't got nothing
and
to do
with
that.
Me. Yeah. But as soon as a white man go and beat the you want a video and then so and so, why not correct my brother and my sister? What's
now,
wrong with that?
Because you got so accustomed to turning the other cheek when
you just don't your cheek ain't even damn there
like
no more.
We don't care anymore.
What about that brother that done had to try to that done tried a numerous of time to correct our sisters and brothers about these
disrespecting each other,
right? And then here go your sister and brother turn on them. Man, stay the fuck out of my business. Blow your brains out. Or then here go this black queen. She rat back with this man the next day. Hey, don't stay out of our business and such and such.
You did your part.
You tried. You corrected that brother. You corrected that sister. That's all you can do.
But see, most people these days on some old bullshit. So a lot of people don't even care to get in folks' business because home come behind it.
Right.
But first of all, as a person,
I know from being a street person, being on the street, if you go out there, and I done seen it one time a dude did it on Facebook. And it went viral. But most times, just like them Crips and stuff you talking about, if you take your black ass out there, talking about what y'all need to do, they finna show you what you need to do.
But that's just situation.
Like telling them to do what? No.
As in trying to do right.
All
right,
Cam.
These drugs off this street.
Let me tell you something. This is not right the way y'all going. Y'all killing each other. Y'all selling drugs. No folks ain't trying to hear that shit, man.
But it has worked because gang members have got together and called truces.
They Crips and Blood. These some new age Crips and Blood.
They like down some other shit.
Because perhaps the society.
Baby, you gotta keep talking. This like survival of the fittest. Ain't nobody curses in this conversation.
What I'm gonna say is, you gotta get in there and deep in your mind. I've been in the corner of my life. I used to be in a wild grass coming mall in Dover.
I been to that motherfucker, that sucker there. If I see a dude like you finna hit the girl, I'm gonna hey bro, man. Oh no, no. I done that. I did that a lot of times. Like,
right.
Because whenever
they not been about me, they're like, no, they ain't the way to go. Like, bro.
If he's
and
still
I approach him a certain way, like not disrespectful. I'm just saying, like, dude, just talk it out. Like that, like. That ain't my business. And he said, he kind of like, oh, yeah.
Like, remember this, yeah, remember you told the situation with you being in your truck.
But I ran into a brother that would have an open mind and that would listen to
this. We was in Montgomery. Yeah.
We got a lot of brothers that minds don't want to open.
That's why I said right now.
It's hard to tell them.
But right
like
now,
I said, even you could.
Some of the older ones too now.
Right.
But even I was at that point, like, if he's like, he gonna only use the hand, we want to fight. Yeah, I thump him. I was at that to that point too. My hands ain't out of date. I didn't get good. But I felt like it don't come to that. I'm coming to him a certain way. My spirit was good. You know what I'm saying?
But everybody's spirit is not tempting to sovereignness.
But then you said, if you get to it, you're going to put your hands. That's me. That's
but I ain't come with that.
But I'm saying, my approach
was like this right here.
Never come to violence.
My approach, like,
listen. If you're trying to tell nobody,
think about it. Think about it.
They got to learn.
Before we fight, bro.
No, I walk away.
I know listen, I got in your business, but before we fight, I'd rather walk away because that's what I'm trying to tell you.
Exactly.
This is my whole approach. Hey, brother, can I talk to you about something? You don't know me, I don't know you. You can talk to me about something.
Yeah.
So if he's dead, like, you just need to go ahead.
I never had bad luck like that.
But I'm saying,
it could have happened. It could have happened.
But see, because the energy and the force is there. You know what I'm saying? And it's not going to over.
You don't know me. Can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah.
We already said, hey, bro,
catch somebody to the point of they don't want to hear that shit, man.
But see,
they are angry on that. Once you say, hey, bro, look, bro.
Sometimes, majority of the time, when people are angry on stuff, it's your approach, yes.
That approach works.
It's your approach.
That approach works.
Because you don't know, you don't know what a person has went through for that particular day. And then sometimes, as black men, I hate to say it, I love my black men, but they don't know how to relax and understand the point that you don't have to continue to, you fighting out there in the streets. When you out there got a job and you working, you don't have to come home and fight and take it out on your queen or your kids and stuff like that. And even with the point of just stepping up, being a man, meaning like not just saying, well, hey, you got to be out here working the sweat of your brow, nothing like that. But just having a family as a whole, sitting down at a table on Sunday, being able to have a conversation about what happened today, what you encountered, what stressed you out. But see, white folks, they do that. They sit down and eat their goddamn moon pies and shit. Let me finish. Moon pies and shit, and then everything fine. You don't tuck Johnny in. Johnny feels secure, but you got that little black boy in there. I sure want to talk to Dad about baseball. Right. I want to talk to Dad about this girl that I like. He ain't got time to do that because guess what? Daddy is on the phone. He got his wife or in the bathroom, pimping, trying to see what else going on. When you allow negativity to come into your space, that's what that comes in and that happens and it takes over. So then you were fighting against yourself as well as the world. And who fault that is? That was your choice. You chose to do that. Well, you got to step up and be who you're supposed to be.
Well, let's not make it sound biased, you know, because when we said black people, we talking about a whole. And so we got to put everything in perspective.
Right.
Because just as a black man, no, I don't want to bring this shit in from out there. But when I come in here and receive some of the same shit, how am I supposed to act?
You're supposed to sit down and we're supposed to talk about it.
We can't talk when you the one bringing the shit to me. I won't talk because I won't comfort when I come home.
I was just giving an example. But when it comes down to men and women, with the woman being at home and dealing with a child being rebellious from at home, a woman, if she's not going out working or whatever the case may be, she need that king to come through that door to talk to Johnny because Johnny's upset because somebody was bullying him at school and the dad couldn't be there. It's just giving an example. We women and men, they're both battling that. So you got to be able to communicate within the situation and stop looking at the point of pointing fingers. Well, I had to deal with this today or that today. You got to be able to listen to me, and I got to be able to listen to you. And we got to be able to listen to our kids, too. You see what I'm saying? They going to tell you something, too.
A child can. We know this nature. But a man don't want to come home with a woman when her nature is on and she don't went crazy, the kids don't ran her damn crazy, and she want to take it out on him.
But see, that's what I'm saying. That's true. That is true.
The point is a whole. We, in perspective, we...
Communication.
We have to do a part to let each other know how
and that's why we are to each Africans other. That's why Africans meditated a whole lot. You got to go back to your rituals. With what the first conversation what we have, we going to get back to doing stuff. You got to be able, just like what Kevin said, you got to know who you are and what you are. You got to stop letting other people think for you and decide to make the decisions for you. If you keep going off of what Kumbaya said for tell you to do, you're gonna be lost for the rest of your life. You got to be able to know what it is.
I'm gonna tell you something, and you might, anybody, you can use all kind of words you want to say. You can use luck, you got lucky, whatever. Energy is a lot. I just skim through life like unscathed because of my energy,
right?
I don't rub nobody the wrong way. You feel where I'm coming from? Mm-hmm. I deal you, I'm gonna do you right. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, you'll get right from me now.
Like you said, so since you give out positive comes back.
Coming back. It's going to come back. I've been unscathed. I had a lot of shit happen to me.
And that's not always true because, that's why good, bad things always happen to good people.
Not always, but most of the time, bad things happen to good people.
They send out positive vibe, but the negative energy try to break in.
I look at it a certain way. Like, I done been ran over. I done been burnt. My leg been burnt. Nope. I done had a lot of shit happen to me. Right here, stabbed. Right here on the back. You know what I'm saying? Dude was stabbed. Wrong dude. He didn't know who he was stabbed. I almost got stabbed. Right there, stabbed. He don't even know who he was fucking with. He escaped. You know what I'm saying? I ain't fucking him up bad. I just took care of him. But he all right. But the thing is, I made it. You know what I'm saying?
You made it through.
I made it through. But, right. Like, that it would, a lot of my, it ain't supposed to happen to me, I feel like. You know what I'm saying?
Do you actually believe you made it through because
now,
you still...
No, I'm going to say, so, like I said, that one meant for me, right?
Right.
The burnt on the leg. That's why I say it one meant for me. Trey and Calvin Jackson, Trey, you know Trey, I don't know. He ended up cooking some sausage or something on the stove, and it caught on fire. Instead of him putting a lid or something on fire, me, I'm out there standing by the front door. His knee standing right there. I kind of say her life. Doc said I say her life. I got most of the. He instead of him putting a lid on, like I say, he'll throw it outside. Fight.
So damn!
All that shit hit me.
What in the world?
And it hit her on the face, but the little bit just hit my leg and bounced out my leg and hit her. If it went directly and hit her, she would die. Doc said it. Automatic human being.
Wow.
So see, what could have been something bad, it was perfect. You exactly. saved her life.
Right.
You got to start looking at the bad and turn it into a positive, because it is a positive and all that.
Yes.
We could go along and we can make the change strong. It would be hard to divide because we know the value of each other.
But we got to start correcting each other when we see things that are wrong.
I'll give an example with
the point of, like you said earlier, about the projects. Mm-hmm. We go to school to be what it is like with the women. They get to the point of they're going out to people's houses, you know,
social work and stuff.
Like anything that's dealing with an institution is to demote the whole foundation as a whole. People don't know that. So you got, back in the day, if you look in the history books, they used to have it to the point of the social worker come in to check to see if that black, the living conditions and stuff.
And standards and stuff.
The government did it to try to make sure that the black man wasn't in, because we They don't understand that a black man is always under attack. Yeah, you finna be kicked out of their apartment, but hey, we can't do that. But see, but with that being said, you got to think about the whole big picture. Why do you can't just...
Why they got different filing taxes statuses?
Well, I mean,
you got head of household, you got filing single, you got this and you got that, you're filing single, right. You head of household, right. Filing single, you, what?
How they did kept the black man out, so that refrain back
when, they being nosy,
once
right?
They kept the black man out, that left the black woman having to see about the kid and needed financial,
Listen.
So that's for the that way the welfare come in.
Yes.
Now the point of where you receive the welfare is back to the point of control, depending on the government.
And that's why we as black people, okay.
Listen.
It's okay to be on welfare. I mean, it's out there. You need it. You use it.
If you need help, you need help.
But get off of it. Yeah. Don't be dependent on it because that's control.
Yes, right.
Then they control you where now your man, the children fall, can't be in the
not
home.
Not only that, but it's a limit to what you get and how much you can have once you're receiving it.
They're going to keep you at below poverty level because you got to be below poverty level to even qualify for it.
Mm-hmm. But did you hear what I just said?
Right.
How nosy they are to know who in your household. You get an information name. They asking you questions, and you ain't know why you asking that. They asking you held a household.
Mm-hmm.
Cause they want to know if the motherfucker a dude in your house.
Right.
You telling them without even telling them that. You ain't know you telling them. I ain't find a held a household. So that a dude in the house. See what I'm saying? You married? Find a separate. Asking you questions about the dude again. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Married filing together. They still want to see the man in the house. So I'm saying that's filing taxes, statuses. You see how they being slick? Ask you, is a man in your house? They ask you if a man in your house all different kind of ways. A man is a powerful thing. You see what I'm saying? Not discrediting the women. Women are very, very like, they're needed in everybody's household. You know what I'm saying? They're prominent.
Right.
They're needed.
Right.
They ask you all these manly questions. What a man is. What a man is. They want to know the man is.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they try to control the black man. Black man, I want him in prison. I want him with this status. You can't get your license because you got this. You know what I'm saying? You can't even earn vote, nothing. But that taxation without representation. I go to prison. I can pay taxes. but I can't vote.
Yeah.
That's taxation without representation.
Right.
Come on, now how you gonna take that right from me?
Right.
Rose, you get one coming from. You see what I'm coming from?
Mm-hmm.
But that's how they slide that stuff in the slick. They slick with it now.
I'm sorry, I don't have any eyes.
No, it's fine. They very slick with it.
So it's just so many different things that you have to.
I don't care right now.
That you have to do or try to get to when it comes down to. Trying to get a foundation back as a whole, you just can't give up on just the point of saying I'm gonna pray about it. You got to go through all of that within
And see, the thing is, me.